your job is so 24/7, you can't start being like, I believe in this to be a role model if you actually don't. So my rule has always been to be myself. Having said that, when I garnered such a large audience and I understood that I had an influence, I was like, well, I have the opportunity to also do something positive with this. And I feel in my heart that if I don't do something positive with it, it's just a wasted opportunity. Now add that with the grudge on my shoulder from being an Indian woman, and you have this really large desire to help issues around gender equality. I think that's where my heart lies the most. A lot of my work is around girls being able to go to school and girls having equal rights in parts of the world and access to healthcare and all that stuff. That comes from the fact that, you know, when I was born, a lot of people were unhappy with having an Indian girl, especially because I have an older sister, so we're a family of two sisters, and so many people were so sad at my birth, literally. And so I've had that grudge on my shoulder, and I know that quite transparently. Like, I can say that very honestly. My whole life has kind of been a little bit of a, I'm going to prove you wrong, and I'm going to... And I always say, don't work hard to prove people wrong. Prove your lovers right instead. Yeah. I always believe in that. Having said that, there's still a lot of people suffering because girls are born. And so I do feel a strong passion in my heart to do something with the following I have. When you go back to one of my greatest achievements, the one that's not as shiny as the rock is actually when I announced my world tour, the first one, A Trip to Unicorn Island. I made sure I did it in India first. That was important for me to announce it in India, my parents' motherland. And I went to Punjab to visit my dad's dad, my grandfather, and he greeted me with like flower gardens, and he said something to me where I was like, whoa. Probably met him like 3 times in my life maybe, and he goes, you know, I was wrong. You are the girl, the person and a girl in our family who has had the most success. And that was like a huge statement for him to make, because I remember what it was like for my mom when I was born. And so, well, wow. I don't remember, she told me. But yeah, so that was a really big achievement for me.
That's huge.
Yeah, and I like felt it for my mom. My mom was like, straight, you know? So like I have that force where my mom like was like, no, I have a second daughter and like she's gonna be awesome, and she believed in me, and I just hope I've done justice to that.
I think you've done so much more. I think it's amazing to see someone defy cultural traditions, and someone who's, especially, see, I didn't realize that it was that like somewhat closed off when you were born as well, around the belief of having a girl, etc. You've like blown that.
No, but even me, like I you know, I was just working on writing a script, and that's when I really like dived into my childhood, and I was like, wow, I had my wedding entrance song picked out before I knew what I wanted to do in life.
Yeah.
Like, that's not who I am today, but as a young girl, that was true, and it just goes to show how much it was bedded in my mind that my optimal achievement would be getting married.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And so
I just don't want to continue that pattern. So whatever I can do with my following to teach young girls that you can get married, that's great, congratulations, that's fine, but that doesn't have to be your
defining
defining moment, you know what I mean? And I think that's important.